Hello students, today we are going to learn English, class 7th, 4.3, The Red-Headed League. This story is very interesting story having two parts and both the parts involves suspense and mystery. This story is written by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. In this video, today we will study part 1, that is Mr. Wilson's story. Now, this story is told by Sherlock Holmes' friend, Mr. Watson. Okay, so let's see the story. The Red-Headed League. Now, League means an association or a formal group of people. Part 1, Mr. Wilson's story. When I call upon my friend, Mr. Sherlock Holmes, he was conversing with a visitor who was an elderly man with a fairy red hair. Now here, Watson was narrating the story. What he said, when I was called my friend Sherlock Holmes. Sherlock Holmes was Watson's friend. At that time, this Sherlock Holmes, he was discussing or conversing with one visitor, and that visitor was an elderly man with a fairy red hair. Holmes introduced me to the visitor, Mr. Jabez Wilson. He was a pawnbroker. Holmes asked him to repeat his story for me. He began by showing us an advertisement in a newspaper. He read as follows. Now, when I went to my friend Mr. Sherlock Holmes, at that time he was with one person with a fairy red hair, and his name was Jabez Wilson, and he was a pawnbroker. Pawnbroker means a person who lends money at interest when valuable things are kept with him till the loan is repaid. Okay, in this way he was a pawnbroker, and his hair was fairy red hair. Fairy means what? Very bright in color. And at that time Sherlock Holmes asked this Wilson that you repeat your story once again, and he started telling his story by showing an advertisement in a newspaper, and he read that advertisement. What was the advertisement? It was written here. Just see. To the Red-Headed League. There is a vacancy for a member of the league, and the salary is £4 a week for a normal services. Red-headed men may apply in a person on Monday at 11 o'clock to Duncan Ross at the office of a league, 7 Fleet Street. In this way, the advertisement has came in the newspaper, and this red-headed man means who? This Wilson read this advertisement. The advertisement had appeared in a newspaper 2 months ago. Mr. Wilson's assistant, Vincent Spaulding, had shown it to him. Mr. Wilson liked his assistant Spaulding. He was smart, efficient, and worked for only half the normal wages. But the assistant also had his fault. Every now and then, he left work and went down in the cellar to develop photographs. Photography was his hobby. Now, in this way, this Wilson told that this advertisement had come in the newspaper, and who had shown this advertisement? His assistant. Who was the assistant? Wilson's assistant was Vincent Spaulding, and Wilson liked his assistant very much. Why? Because he was very smart, efficient, and he worked for him only half the normal wages. But this assistant having one fault. What was the fault? Every now and then He left his work and went down in the cellar. Cellar means what? A room below the ground level in a house. Okay, we can say storage room, we can say. Okay, underground room. And he went in that underground room to develop photographs, because this Spaulding has a hobby of photography. Photography was his hobby. Now, next paragraph. Spaulding showed the advertisement to Mr. Wilson and explained to him that an American, the millionaire, Mr. Ezekiah Hopkins, had founded the famous Red-Headed League to help all redheads like himself. Spaulding urged to Mr. Wilson to apply for the job. So, the two of them went to the address given in the advertisement. So, in this way, the Spaulding, his assistant, showed the advertisement to Mr. Wilson and explained him that that the American millionaire, who the Ezekiah Hopkins, he wanted to help these red-headed people. So, we should go there and you should apply for the job. So, both of them went there. Where? At the given address. Fleet Street was full of red-headed people. Mr. Wilson thought that with so much competition, he will not get the job. He wanted to go back, but Spaulding pushed through the crowd and took Mr. Wilson to the office. Now, when they went in that address, Fleet Street, it was full of red-headed people. And why it is full of that street was very much crowded? Because the advertisement asking red-headed men to apply for a well-paying job had appeared in a newspaper, and many red-headed redheads had seen it and come to Fleet Street in response to the advertisement. Okay, so here the Wilson said that now competition is a lot of competition, so we should go back. But the Spaulding, what he did, he pushed through the crowd and took Mr. Wilson to the office. Now, there was nothing in the office but a couple of chairs and a table. A red-headed man sat behind the table. He was a Mr. Duncan Ross, a representative of a red-headed league. He was very pleased to see Mr. Wilson and announced immediately that he was well suited for the job. He shook hands with Mr. Wilson, congratulated him, and told all other candidates to go back. And as soon as this Mr. Duncan Ross, the representative of this red-headed league, saw Wilson, he was very much happy, and he immediately announced that he was a well suited for the job. Well suited means suitable for this job. Okay, and he congratulated him and told other candidates to go back. Mr. Duncan Ross explained that Mr. Wilson would have to be in the office from 10 to 2. 10 to 2 means only 4 hours. If he left the office, he would lose the job. Spaulding assured Mr. Wilson that he would look after Mr. Wilson's business in his absence. The pay was fixed at £4 a week. So, in this way, Wilson accepted the job. Why? Because the pay was very good and the work easy. Besides, he had to work only for 4 hours daily. And Spaulding, his assistant, assured him that he would look after Mr. Wilson's business in his absence. And the work, said Mr. Wilson, you have to copy out the Encyclopedia Britannica. Means only, what is the work? Only Wilson, he had to copy only Encyclopedia Britannica. The pay was very good and the work was light. Mr. Wilson accepted the job and began his work the very next day. Mr. Duncan Ross was there in the office to see Mr. Wilson did his work properly and did not leave the office. He told Mr. Wilson to start with the letter A. Mr. Wilson started writing. He wrote diligently for 4 hours without leaving his place. Mr. Ross would drop in from time to time to see that all was right with Mr. Wilson. At 2 o'clock, he bade Mr. Wilson goodbye and locked the door of the office. In this way, Mr. Wilson started his work. He started writing the encyclopedia. He started from the letter A. And this representative, Mr. Ross, he also, time to time, he came and see that all work is going on smoothly or not. And at the 2 o'clock, he bade. Bade means he said or he tell goodbye to Mr. Wilson and locked the door of the office. Now next paragraph. This went on day after day, Mr. Holmes said, Mr. Wilson, and on Saturday I got my salary. It was the same next week and the same the week after. After a few days, Mr. Duncan Ross came in only once in a while, and after a time he did not come in at all. And my work was going very smoothly and I got my salary also in time. Mr. Wilson continued, 8 weeks had passed like this and I had written about the Abbots, archery, etc. And I hoped that I might get on to B soon. And then suddenly the whole business came to an end. And Wilson continued his story and he told that after 8 weeks I finished my letter A and I might get on letter B. But what happened? Suddenly whole business came to an end. To an end? Holmes asked. Yes, sir. This morning I went to my work as usual at 10 o'clock, but the door was shut and locked with a little note nailed on it. It said, the red-headed league is dissolved. October 9, 1880. Now, today when I went in that shop for doing my work, that shop was closed and I saw one note and on that note it was written that red-headed league is dissolved. Dissolved means what? It means that the organization has come to an end. I was shocked. I did not know what to do. Mr. Wilson went on with his story. I made inquiries at the nearby offices, but none of them knew anything about the league. The rooms had been rented under a false name. I went home and asked my assistant Spaulding for advice, but he could not help me in any way. I want to find out about the league, Mr. Holmes, who they are and why they played with this prank upon me. The whole thing is mystery. That is why I came to you. I have heard a lot about you. In this way, this Wilson continued his story and he said that when I saw that this red-headed league is dissolved, I made an inquiry at the nearby offices also and to my assistant also, but nobody knows about it. Okay, Mr. Wilson made inquiries at the nearby offices about the red-headed league. He also asked his assistant if he knew anything about it. Nobody knew anything about the league. Okay, but somebody played this prank upon me. Prank means evil deed played upon me. Okay. Holmes found Mr. Wilson's story very unusual. He asked Mr. Wilson, this assistant of yours who first called your attention to the advertisement, what is he like? How is that assistant? Tell me that. Who told you about the advertisement first? Then Wilson said, small, stout, with no hair on his face. He has a white splash of acid on his forehead. I thought as much, said Mr. Holmes. Is he still with you? Oh, yes, sir. That will do. Mr. Wilson, I can give you my opinion on this subject in a day or 2 days. Today is Saturday, and by Monday we may come to a conclusion. So in this way, Holmes told to the Wilson that I will study your case and I will give the conclusion within 2 days. Okay, so students, this is the first part of the story. Second part of the story we'll discuss in the next video.